Okay, so there is a man named Nobu Tanaka, Tanaka Nobu, and he is getting, he's under the weather. He's feeling sick, and he's just got a flu shot / cold shot. So he gets a flu shot, and he goes into work because he can't stand being at home anymore, and he's still feeling kind of sick. He works at a medical research lab.
And he's sneezing all over the medical research.
I was going to say, very bad sanitary conditions here.
He literally sneezes into a tissue and then rubs it in his hands into a little ball. So he makes sure that he gets all of the mucus all over his hands and then throws it onto a trash can that's overflowing. So it just kind of rolls away.
Yeah. And so he's feeling under the weather. And then one of his colleagues is kind of like, hey, man, you're still feeling sick, huh? Well, the boss has this new experimental fever drug that you should try, and it's supposed to be able to knock out a cold or a fever really quickly. You should go try it. It's on his desk. And then so he goes to the boss's desk, takes the pills, and then chaos ensues.
It really does.
Turns out that the experimental pills that Nobu has taken somehow had a chemical mixture reaction with the flu shot that he got that emits a gaseous thing that kills everyone around him.
See, I didn't think that it had to do with the flu shot. I think that's just what the pills do. Later you find out that they're, an experimental bioweapon.
Mm-hmm.
I think that the flu shot thing was just a misdirection or was supposed to lead up to him needing the pills.
Mm. See, this is why I think it had to do with the flu shot. Number one, because the Wikipedia says it. That it Number two, because towards the end of the film, the head medical technician, director, people were like, it's not the pills. It's how the pills are mixing with something that's in his diet. And it also the gas that kills everybody interacts with his emotions.
Yeah, I don't remember them saying anything about the diet, but I do remember them saying that the gas that he's emitting that is killing all mammals around him, it becomes stronger when he becomes emotionally more distressed.
Mm-hmm.
And the more calm he is, the less he's emitting it. But by the time that he gets to a point where he's actually terrified, he's killing things within, miles from him.
Yeah. But we never see him calm. Every time we see him, it's just there's death surrounding him for miles.
Although he does remain weirdly chill about that. He's kind of he's not panicking.
Did you know that this is based off of a real life thing?
Yes.
Yeah. Do you want to talk
Gloria
about
Ramirez?
That? Yeah.
And I remember this.
You do?
Oh, yeah. I mean, she's from Riverside.
This happens in the LA area. So you speak about it because you lived through it.
Yeah. Gloria Ramirez was a cancer patient. And they basically, her body and her blood became toxic to people in the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
And several people lost consciousness. A couple people had to be hospitalized and people didn't know what was going on. And as it turns out, at least it's theorized that she had been self-medicating for pain and there was a chemical mixture that ended up causing a very poisonous gas to be released from her body and blood and mm-hmm. et cetera, et cetera. Which quite ironically is strongly carcinogenic.
Thanks for watching that clip from the Anime Movie Podcast. Follow the links in the description below to hear full episodes, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more fun clips like this.